Good morning, all of you. So, since previous two classes, we have been discussing about the seventh chapter. The seventh chapter, as you know, weather, climate, and adaptations of animals to climate. This was the chapter. In this chapter, we had discussed about weather, what is climate. We have studied about the different elements that we are considering while measuring the weather or the climate of a place. We have also studied about measurement of rainfall, humidity, etc. I just told you the name of these devices. Then we had also collected the weather data for a week. I hope you all have recorded this, and in today's class I will be able to see this. So we had drawn the informations about climate of two extreme places in India, and today we will be discussing about climate and adaptations of animals to this climate. So what is climate? We already know. And in extremes of climate, like when it is extremely hot, extremely cold, different kind of animals, they are living in such kind of environment. So how do they live in such kind of conditions? What adaptations or what body changes do they observe to keep themselves living in such kind of climate? That is what we are going to study in today's class. So let us discuss. So climate and adaptations. Climate has a profound effect on all living organisms. Animals are adapted to survive in the conditions in which they live. Animals living in extreme hot or extreme cold condition should have special features for their survival. If an animal wants to survive, and it should have some special kind of features. Features and habits that help animals to adapt to their surroundings are a result of the process of evolution. So, if an animal is living in extremely hot condition, then it should have special features, special kind of body structures for its survival in the extremely kind of hot conditions. Similarly, if an animal is living in a very cold kind of climate or cold condition, its body should have such kind of features which will help it to stay in cold, extremely cold condition. So these features and these habits, they help the animals to adapt to their surroundings, and these changes in the body structures are a result of the process of evolution in animals. Moving further. So, polar regions is a region where there is such kind of extreme condition. So, as you can see from the pictures on the screen, the condition in the polar region is extremely cold. So, it's an extreme climate. So, these regions are covered with snow. It is very cold for most part of the year. For 6 months, the sun does not set. And for the other 6 months, the sun does not rise. In winters, the temperatures are as low as minus 37 degrees Celsius. Animals living there have adapted to this severe condition. So 6 months sun does not set. That is, it's day, almost day. 6 months sun does not rise at all. So the climate, the body of the animals of such kind of climate, they should be adapted for their survival. So such kind of animals, okay, if you see, one of the best examples of animals in the polar regions is the polar bear, okay. So let us see the body adaptations of this polar bear. So as you can see in the picture, they have a white fur. That is, their body is white in color. Fur is there on their body, long hair like outgrowth, that is fur. This helps them to be not very easily visible in the snow. So since they are white in color and they walk through the white snow, so what happened? They are not very easily visible in the snow. It protects them from their predators. So it also helps them in catching the prey. So they can hide away from dangerous animals. They can escape from dangerous animals because their skin is also white and snow is also white. Similarly, after hiding, they can catch their food also. So they have two thick layers of fur on their body. They also have a layer of fat under their skin. They are very well insulated. They have two thick layers of fur on their body and they have a layer of fat under their skin. So they are very well insulated. They move very slowly. They will move very slowly. And they rest often to avoid getting overheated. So immediately after little movement, they will rest. Otherwise, what happens? The temperature is extremely cold. They cannot live. That is the problem. So they move slowly. So on some warm days, they go for swimming. On warm days, what happens? They go for swimming. It is a good swimmer. Polar bear is a good swimmer. Its paws, they are wide and large. Its paws, you can see its paws, okay? It's wide and large. And this will help them to walk in the snow. So warm days, they are going for swimming. And its paws, they are wide and larger and they help them to walk and swim, right? While swimming underwater, it can close its nostrils. So when it swims underwater, it can close its nostrils so that water does not move in. It can remain underwater for a long time. For a long time, it remains underwater. It has a strong sense of smell and it can catch its prey very easily. So water does not move inside its nostrils and it has a strong sense of smell. So it can catch its prey very easily. So you can see the picture of a polar bear. So its muscle hump over shoulders. It's for catching large prey. Small rounded eyes, black nose, okay. Small tail, large furry feet for walking on ice and snow. Long claws for tearing apart the prey. Okay. So the white fur is not easily visible. It has a strong sense of smell. It helps the bear to locate and catch its prey. It has long curved and sharp claws. These help it to walk on the ice. It has a layer of fat under its skin because of which the body gets insulated. So polar bear have excellent sense of smell. This adaptation helps them to find their prey. Polar bears have strong legs. This helps them to swim fast through the icy water. Polar bears have thick, rough, sandpaper-like paws. This helps them grip the slippery ice and get good traction. A polar bear has thick, white fur. This helps it blend into the snow and also stay warm. Polar bears have small ears. These help to keep the body heat from escaping so they can stay warm. Similar, one such organism that lives in the extremely cold region is the penguins. So penguins, its color is also white and it merges with the white background. Almost white except the outer thick fur. So its color merges with the white background. It has a thick skin and it has a lot of fat to protect it from cold. Penguins huddle together, that is they move in groups. Okay. Penguins, they move in groups so that they get a lot of heat when they are moving together. Okay, family pack, they move together. So it has thick skin. You can see the black colored thick skin. So it has a lot of fat to protect it from cold. And penguins will move, always try to move together so that they will keep it themselves to warm. So they are also good swimmers and their body are streamlined. They move in a streamlined way and their feet, okay, the speciality of their feet they have webs, right? And this helps them to keep warm and catch their prey very easily. So with this we are ending today's class. So in today's class we discuss mainly about two main organisms, that is the polar bear and the penguins, which are living in extremely cold condition. Okay, so I hope you understood the class and waiting for you in the online class. Thank you.